Right?
There we go. Oh.
It's the only single to make the top 40. And the success of this track was helped by its inclusion in the soundtrack to Crocodile Dundee, which had been a huge success the previous year. Call that a knife? This is a knife. Remember that? And talking of movie stars, Bruce Willis is up 4 to number 7. Respect yourself.
Thank you.
Me?
Him and Julie.
Say you what?
Him and Julie was in there together.
Where are you going, what?
I might do Matty Lane, it depends.
Yeah.
If I get a gap. Don't know, do you? Is he in it?
No, he's not. My bastard. No.
Next year, Die Hard will come out.
Did you want to make
Bruce an absolute megastar?
Shaking his head.
Climbing one place to this week's number six. Alison Moyet, weak in the presence of youth.
Whichever you want, though.
I'm asking you.
Hey?
I'm asking you.
That's alright, whatever you want.
What's going on here? I'm tired just talking about it.
With special programs looking back on her
somebody was selling trays of eggs.
Yeah.
And wanted to put them on our site. Put them on. Can't remember what, how much they were going for now. I don't know, love, I didn't look proper.
I'm the only one. This one looks like it's got a limp.
Yeah. Got a big fucking arse, hasn't she?
Hey?
She's got a big arse.
You're looking at her arse. Why are you looking at her arse?
You can see it. Can't fucking miss it, can you? Free-range eggs available for purchase. Our eggs are both vibrant yolks and rich flavour, providing a wholesome addition to your meal. £6 a tray.
Okay.
See?
£6?
That's what it says. Thanks. Do you deliver? Joshua Smith and Tommy Dixon's, yes. White eggs and brown eggs. Big ones.
No.
I said they look big.
No.
Fucking
hell. I don't
like
that busy, have you?
No. Something going on. What? Have you heard something on the with Sally Traffic saying about A628 and Mosham? Weird, isn't it?
Mm. I wonder if that's going in circles. I saw that near our house, that plain orange tail.
Yeah.
It's easy to get that, isn't it? Orange tail.
Oh. Hey?
True retrievers and a sausage dog.
No.
Because I can't stand anyone who's in the business. They're in the public eye and they won't stop for a minute. Give someone a footy or an autograph. And there are some who are like that. And I thank God I never bump into them because I'd have to tell them what I thought. It's your fault. You're looking well on here, I have to say. Great, honestly. Sometimes my reason has a little go at me, she said. Oh, you just couldn't be seeing him. I said, I know, I'm glad to be alive, Reed. And I love Liverpool, I love where I live. And I go down the street, and I must get my catchphrase shouted at me 50 times a day. And fellas all know that. Yeah, fellas.
Okay. Coming from?
Love Boy George. Always great value in interviews. One of my favourite quotes of his is,
"Bread."
I had to write in a different way because I'm not in a bad place.
He's lost the fucking plot.
So there's no one I want to get revenge on.
He's going to get fucking told off for that.
Bread. Saturday afternoon, it's Pick of the Pops.
Pick of the Pops?
Counting down the chart this week in 1987. Man Parish are down 7 at number 20 with Male Stripper. Down 10 at 19, Percy Sledge, When a Man Loves a Woman. Genesis up 1 at 18 with Tonight, Tonight, Tonight. And down 7 at 17, The Jets and Crush on You. Nick Kamen, Loving You is Sweeter Than Ever, is up 1 at 16. And Peter Gabriel, new entry at 15 with
Hey?
Cafe that pub. 5 to 13, yeah. With the moonlighting
theme. Up 3 to 12, erasure, it doesn't have to be. And up 3 at 11, you gotta fight for your right to party. That's the Beastie Boys. Up 6 at 10, sign of the times from Prince. Janet Jackson, massive climber, up 22 to 9 with Let's Wait a While. And down 3 at 8, live it up from Mental as Anything. Bruce Willis, Respect Yourself, is up 4 to 7.
It's gone again.
Is
up 1 at 6. Freddie Mercury is up 1 to 5 with The Great Pretender. A new entry at number 4 for U2 with or without you. There's a long move at number 3 for Jackie Wilson, I Get the Sweetest Feeling. And down 1 place to number 2, Boy George, and Everything I Own. Which means we have a brand new number 1.
You don't notice
it's up 1 place from last week's number 2 for Mel and Kim and Respectable.
Songs that remind me of Nuki.
Yeah.
Kids were little.
Yeah.
Or dumping there. In that pub.
Yeah.
That's a pub called now. Mermaid, on it. Eh? Hey?
Nearly 2 o'clock now.
Hello? It's a long time just to get here.
Mel and Kim Appleby,
it's their only week at number one, but they will stay in the top 10 for 7 weeks.
You know that 50-mile stretch, and then you've got a queue at
the end,
haven't you?
In 1999.
That's what I thought, that's why I didn't bother getting on.
This is
Radio 2 on
BBC Cells.
And on your smart speaker, like going back to come back on yourself as well, aren't you?
BBC News at 2 o'clock, this is Justine Green. The Islamic State group has released what it says is a photo of the four men who attacked a concert hall near Moscow yesterday. The group says the picture, which shows masked men, is evidence that it was behind the attack. Russia has blamed Ukraine, which Kyiv has dismissed as absurd. At least 133 people were killed when gunmen entered the Krokus City Hall and began shooting at random. In a televised address, Vladimir Putin claimed the suspects had been arrested while trying to flee to Ukraine.
All those who were shooting and killing people were found and detained. They tried to hide and were moving towards Ukraine. From the Ukrainian side, a window to cross the border had been prepared.
The United Nations Secretary General has travelled to the Egyptian border with Gaza to repeat his call for a humanitarian ceasefire between Israel and Hamas. The UN has warned of catastrophic levels of hunger in the territory. And Antonio Guterres said it was time for the guns to fall silent, for Israeli hostages to be released, and for a surge of aid to be allowed into
like
Gaza.
Long time since we've been
and
down
I want
here.
Palestinians yeah. in Gaza to know you are not.
We've been in
alone.
This car, have we?
No.
People around the world are outraged by the horrors we are all witnessing in real time. I carry the voices of the vast majority of the world. We have seen enough.
The think tank, the Resolution Foundation, says the number of people leaving the workforce due to long-term sickness is at its highest since the 1990s. It says it rose from 2.1 million in July 2019 to a peak of 2.8 million in October last year. The government says its recent budget measures are estimated to boost the workforce by 300,000. The authorities in Nigeria say 17 students and a woman who was snatched from a school in the northwest of the country 2 weeks ago have been rescued. Senators are urging the government to do more to prevent such kidnappings. Our Africa regional editor Will Ross reports.
You shouldn't keep me eyes open, sir.
Yeah,
it's
all right when you get out, you get warm, cook a bit of fresh air.
He said the students have been reunited with their families.
I'm going to wait for a long time.
He was involved in the rescue operation. What we don't know is whether any ransom was handed over. A senior military commander has promised that people in Sokoto State will now be free from the kidnapping gangs. But in recent years, it's become clear that this is a lucrative business and will be hard to stop. The raid on Sangaya School happened just 2 days after almost 300 students and staff were seized in Kaduna State. They're all still missing.
Cancer charities have praised the Princess of Wales's bravery, saying others with the disease will be encouraged by the release of her video message yesterday. There have been international messages of support for Catherine after she revealed she's having preventative chemotherapy. That's the BBC News. It's 3 minutes past two. Travel news now.
Thank you, Justine. Well, let's start on the M62.
You may have heard of
this very unpleasant accident that happened about 2 o'clock
right?
this morning between junctions 22 and 24, Rippington and Huddersfield. It was closed for several hours in both directions. However, the westbound carriageway has now reopened, but the eastbound carriageway remains closed. So you can imagine there is quite a queue on the approach to that. And one of the other problems is heading up towards Surrey Bridge on the 58. Very heavy traffic as people try and divert away from the area. You'll find delays in other areas around the junctions as well. In other news, the M6 still queuing a little bit southbound as you head from junction 10 down towards junction 9. There was an accident there earlier on. That is now gone, but there's this residual queue. There's been a series of problems on the western section of the M25 around junction 12, the M3, 10, 9, that sort of area. It's a bit stop-start on the clockwise side as a result of that. The Blackhall Tunnel in East London is closed southbound due to roadworks. That's closed all weekend as you come down from the A13 all the way down through to Greenwich. Traffic is running northbound through the southbound tube. So obviously one tunnel is being shared by two ways. That's all the travel news for now. The number is 08700 100 200.
Now,
welcome back, Pop Pickers, for the next hour. I'll be taking you back to a year so good, Prince wrote a song about it, 1999. This was the year that we struggled with cardboard specs in order to see the first total eclipse visible in Britain since 1927. It was also the year Sunny Delight was found to turn people orange. The BBC launched their latest tech development. It was the red button. And Manchester United became the first English club in history to win the treble of Premier League, FA Cup and European Cup in the same season. Let's count down the top 20. Space Dust and you at 20. Well, let's get down at 19. It's I Wish I Could Fly by Roxette. And we start with Tupac. Described by the press at the time as sounding like a mix of New Order and Nirvana. It had entered and peaked at number 5. Down 9 to 14, the Manic Street Preachers, You Stole the Sun From... Janet Jackson, Let's Wait a While, up 22 places to number 9. It's 1987, the year Dirty Dancing came to the cinemas, starring Patrick Swayze and Jennifer Grey. But you know, the casting could have been very different. Winona Ryder, Sarah Jessica Parker, and Sharon Stone were all considered for the baby role. For Johnny, it could have been Billy Zane, Val Kilmer, or Benicio del Toro. But Patrick Swayze's background in ballet helped him secure the role. Down 3 at 8, mental as anything.
Why she's not moved it?
I don't know, Chris.